Hello everybody, Max with A1 Website Pro, and I want to show you this real cool program that I got that I use all the time for my images. So basically this is what you're going to be learning. All these images here in this particular folder here, you can see at the bottom here they're 1.65 megabytes, this one's 2 megabytes, this one's 1.3 megabytes, that's 1.4, and that's 1.78 megabytes. Well, let me show you this little program that I have. I'm just going to come over here. I already have all the settings set. I'm going to show you how to do that later, but I'm going to hit compress and let it go through its compression stage. And you notice that the compression finished in 4.7 seconds. Click OK, and then let me get this out of the way so I could show you what the sizes went down to. And you could see right here, this baby, if I click on that, that's 148 kilobytes. So over here it's 1.78 megabytes. You know, an entire web page is only supposed to be 2 megabytes. So you could imagine on your web page, if you wanted to upload all 5 of these pictures, you know, you would have it most of your web page limit done within one picture. But now you can very easily upload all of these and still be under a megabyte. Now it's important that you understand here this megabytes, bytes, kilobytes to megabytes. So 1,000 kilobytes is 1 megabyte. 1,000 megabytes is 1 gigabyte. But if you could just remember that 1,000 kilobytes is 1 megabyte, and then look at these images now, and look at this baby picture is only 148 kilobytes. That's not even a third of a megabyte. So that's what's important. That's what we're going to be learning in this tutorial. So what you want to do is head on over to this particular website. It's called sarasoft.com, and you want to download this Caesium, this image composer. Now, once you click on this download link, it's going to take you to another section over here on Foss Hub. And basically, you're going to download this Windows installer right here. And then you just download the file. It's about 15 megabytes, and you set it up on your computer. Now, I recommend that whenever you get ready to optimize your images, okay, that you have, I'll show you what I did right here in my pictures. I made a folder called Caesium, and here's my originals. Okay, these are my original images that are full, and what I did is I made a copy of them, and that's optimized copy is. In fact, here's what I'll do. I'll just go ahead and get rid of these, and I'll show you exactly how I performed this. I downloaded these images to in full resolution, uncompressed, to my computer. Now, whenever you want to make sure that you're not going to ruin your original images, you always just want to make a copy of it and then work in the copy of that file. So if you highlight the folder like this and hit Control C on your keyboard, then Control V on your keyboard, you'll notice here that it automatically makes a copy for you. Now, I'm going to right click and select new folder. The other thing you could do is you could always go up here and click new folder. And these are going to be this is going to be the output. Okay. So that's the output folder. And that's how I got here. I'm just going to open that. You can see that this folder's empty. And this folder optimized hyphen copy, that's where we have that at. Let me go ahead and bring over my image, my Caesium image compressor. Now, so you can see it all. Let me go ahead and make this a little bit bigger for you, and so you can see how we do this. Now, if you wanted to do one image at a time, you could always click this here and add your pictures. But I like to do a folder. This is all about bulk compression. So what we'll do is we'll navigate to the optimized copy, you know, under pictures, and then we'll go to Caesium. And then optimize copy. You notice I'm not touching the original folder, but I'm going to double click optimize copy, then click select folder. Now right away we have those images load up in here. Now as we scroll down, we can also add more images, or you can remove images where you could preview those images in this folder. But here's where I want to get into the details. You want to save your images online for your website. You want to save them in a JPEG or .jpg or .jpeg. You can see here that the format we're using is .jpg. You don't want to use PNG or BMP or anything like that. You want to convert them all to JPEG. So no matter what they are, we want them converted to JPEG. Here is the quality settings. You notice I set the quality to 25. All right. Now, let's say that I wanted to set the quality to 22. All right. Now, notice up here under quality, it does not have a listing. So, but whenever I click this button right here, set quality, now it sets all the quality to 22. But let's say, well, 22 might be a little bit too low. Maybe I want to go up to 24. Now, notice it doesn't change up there until I hit set quality. So I set the quality to 24. And you can also change the quality by sliding this little cursor to the left or to the right. I put same for all because I want all of the images to be 24. Right here, I could probably come here to the man image or the people image, and I could set that to a different quality if I unselected same for all. But I'm just going to put same for all here. Now, along with that, your computer screen can only show 72 pixels per square inch. Okay, that's just the way it is. So I elected to resize the images by a percentage. You can also resize them by an absolute parameter. You know, if you wanted everything 100 pixels by 100 pixels, you could do that. But I'm just going to resize them by a percentage, and I'm going to take them down 50%. So let's just scroll these down all the way to 50%. And then I want to keep the aspect ratio. Like if it's 5 inches wide by 3 inches high, I just want it, I want it to stay like that. I don't want it to deform my image. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is go here and I'm going to select apply, and you'll notice right up here the new resolution. They all automatically changed according to the original size of the images. Okay. So we're going to resize them down 50%. Now over here in my output folder, if you click on these three dots, it's going to bring up your folders. We can navigate to pictures. We'll go to Caesium, and then I'm going to select output as my folder where I want the images to go after they're compressed. Okay. Now you could here have it remember your last folder, or optimize them in the same folder as the input folder. So that means that it would overwrite the images that you have in your folder. Okay, so that's why I said at the outset, it's always nice if you make another copy of your folders just in case you mess up. All right. So, and then the suffix, you could put your suffix at the end, .jpeg or whatever. But we're just going to leave that blank and let the program do that for us. And now we're going to hit compress. It's going through. It's compressing all the images. You notice it happened in 3.27 seconds. I'll select OK. And let me get the Caesium image compressor out of the way. So here we have the original image. And we have, that is 1.65 megabytes. And now look at this. This item here is only 106 kilobytes. And let me double click that. And if we enlarge that image, and let me bring it over here because it came up on one of my other computer screens here. But there you go. There's the new compressed image. That's a fraction of the original. And so let's take a look at the original. There's the original image. So really not that much of a difference. And if you're worried about it making a difference, then what you want to do, if you see a difference that you don't like, just take this quality and start moving it to the right. The further to the right you move, the less it'll take out. right? And that's how you can optimize, bulk optimize images. Now, in Caesium, there you can also do this this image compressing online. Let me show you where you can do that at. Right here where it says online compressor, you could select this and upload your images there. And if you're on Linux or a Mac OS and you want to do the command line, you can actually download it from the GitHub code and download that to your computer so you can have some fun in the terminal. But anyway, I wanted to make this as easy as possible and to show people how easy it is to optimize your images so that you have a fast loading website, because this day and age, if it doesn't load fast and if you don't catch their eye within a second or two, then bye-bye, right? All right, this is Max with A1 Website Pro. I hope this tutorial was beneficial to you. Please leave a comment in the comment below, smash that like button, and share me with your friends if you think I could help them. I'll talk to you soon. Thanks. Bye.